it's like a
cement.
It's got a choke and one Ouroborg and some Sylvan Scrying. And it's got like a Mind Bend. So it's like.
Which one is Mind Bend? I don't recognize that card.
You change the text of a card from like a land type to a land type.
So choke any of their, like, whatever swamps. They're all swamps with Ouroborg.
And if they're like non basic lands, then you can Mind Bend the Ouroborg.
Yep.
And then choke and just nothing on taps.
There's mine, pick yours. That sounds interesting. Would you like to cut mine? Ah, you got me. Going first, I take it?
Yeah.
Alright.
Did you cut me?
Yes, I did. Okay. We were good? Alright, let's see if I can do this. No. But I'm gonna try. Let's make sure that's right. Alright. He's looking at his cards upside down. Why? Why would he do such a thing? Okay, I think this card is blank against you. Going down? Alright.
Going down.
I'm pretty sure against his deck, that card does nothing. That's why sometimes I wonder whether this is worth being a 4 of in the deck. I find that a fair number of times it ends up just not doing anything for me in the match. But. No,
how long
I think
you hit a million views?
I'm sorry?
How long until you hit a million views?
Until I hit a million views. Well, we crossed 55,000, I want to say, last week.
Yeah.
So, not
there
yet.
I saw, like, some of your videos are, like, over 500. Like, ridiculous.
Yeah. My most watched video is a Legacy one. It's Manaless Dredge versus Rakdos Zombardment. It's not because Zombardment's any good. It's just because it has Manaless Dredge, and when you type in Manaless Dredge, it comes up pretty high in the results. So, that'll do it. It's Wesley and I doing our thing.
I think it does that with, like, bug effects too.
Yeah. I think it's now my third most watched is Simic Infect. This was before Tom Ross made Simic Infect a real thing. And so when he did, people started watching the video. But my list is so out of date. And my opponent's Devin. He has a Blightsteel Colossus and a Sneak and Share deck. So it's while we were still building up to the point we needed to be.
Yeah, I'll roll regularly first, but I can find just, like, obviously, like, in their pockets and things. And then you can roll search checks to see if you can find anything as well.
I think I missed that one. I think they're filling out their audience, yeah.
This is the stuff that just goes like this.
Alright, we're going to start off with a Gemstone Cavern, exiling... I know it's your turn, not mine, but it's part of the card. If it's in my opening hand and I'm not playing first, which is true. Just a second. Exiling Spellskite. It'll now tap for any color. Alright, and now you can go.
Alright.
I'll do you.
One
pack.
Did you get first? Oy.
Yeah.
Wasteland. Aegis of the Gods. I have Hexproof.
Delta, so I'm happy with that.
Nice!
So.
And
then
go,
in
bro.
The same pack, I got a 4 of High Sentinels.
I've opened, like, 4 or 5 green fetches.
Is High Sentinels worth anything?
Oh, Aegis, I have Hexproof. Is High Sentinels? Honestly, I don't know. I wish I did. I'm sorry.
Yeah, it's whatever. I mean, it's modern day. I mean,
yeah.
Not many people know.
I'm sorry.
Standard card. See, that's the thing. I just opened a bunch.
Nihilith.
I split 4 Theros, 4 cons, and then Theros all trash. With the exception of...
Oh, it's graveyard. Okay.
Yeah, all trash. No, right.
No, I'm sorry.
No. I was hoping for Thought Seasons, because that's the last card that I need.
Sure. Definitely understood. Hey, sorry, I'm kind of just trying not to die here. Swing 2 at you to start. Let's see. Mine. And you. You want to be a. Oh, you have yours. Might be a little hard to
see.
Yeah, so put you to 18 to start. Let me make sure that's on screen. That's on screen. Okay. Main 2. Nihilith looks really nice against me right now, actually.
And you see that it's 500 gold standard he's like the Sultan's seal. Mm-hmm. And
Æther Vial?
500 Sultan gold. You see that
we're actually
going to
pop
the,
your.
While running out,
it makes just two, not two of any color. We're going to pop your even stronghold and you'll remove a counter.
Around 30,000 copper pieces.
And then I'll pass the turn to you. Now that I know the deck, I think I know the deck well enough. Yeah, you're not getting anything else. Okay.
What game are we on?
Oh, just game one. We just got started.
Okay.
Nice bet.
For a minute it caught.
Swing tip. Slow beats. Very, very, very slow beats. You can remove another counter.
So it would be
100
copper.
We'll take one. Mm-hmm. Yeah, this looks like a game that Bree played against you a while back.
If you have two more of them.
Pass turn.
I don't know, I rolled.
We'll see. And now that Nihilith, did you remove the counter?
That
Nihilith is making Wasteland and Horizon Canopy look awful. Well, that depends on how quickly I can kill you from here. Hit 2 to 12. Take 1, go to 18, and play a Phyrexian Revoker, naming Wood Elemental. I honestly don't know that I have any targets in your deck for Phyrexian Revoker. Anything I can name, because it has to be a non-land. So, yeah. I can't think of anything. Let's see, there's Shardless Agent. Anyway, pass turn. Shardless Agent, there's Bloodbraid Elf. There's not a, is it Armada Worm? I don't know, whatever it's called. Not Armada Worm. Oh, dear goodness. The 6-drop Cascade. And because they're triggered abilities, that won't do much. Flash in. Revoke. Naming Stormcrow. Why not?
No, you know what? You have it.
There's no reminder text on suspend. I think I get it.
No, it's banned. It's banned.
Some of the colors are behind. Other colors are behind.
Swing 8. I'm going to try to put you to 4.
He didn't really think he fit.
Pass turn. That's game.
Two blasts of
right.
Fire.
Yeah, it gets you to 1.
Just never got the green.
Hey. That same dude.
Green or the red or the white.
Oh, jeez. Let's try this again, though. I think you got it. I think you can do this. Especially when you're on the play. There's mine. Jules. He's being cute over behind the camera. There we go. So you're on the play?
Bless the deck, Evangeline. Bless the deck.
I'm calling it EVA, actually. I'll show you why in a bit. There's a little story behind the deck's name. Yeah, I forgot to take you out too, didn't I? Going down to get cheese. Okay, this doesn't look like a very representative game of your deck.
That was like, well, it doesn't matter if I go down, though. It's just like the same hand that I had before, which is weird.
I gotcha. But I mean, your deck has a ton of lands.
I'm only drawing one kind of them.
Ah, gotcha then.
I'm getting all the blue-red I want.
She's gonna be up all night. You know that, right?
Nothing wrong with that. Says the new parent who apparently doesn't know how in over his head he is. Yeah, this is also going to make my deck look weird too, because this is not how it usually plays out.
You should get those foil Japanese star upgrades and start a college
boy. Oh man, that would be a college.
It was like 8,000 for four of them.
Oh my god.
Oh, well, that was yeah. I didn't realize it was, I actually wrote it down on
the. I remember the days of Legacy when Countergoyf was a deck. It was a top, well, I say top tier, not tier one. Jeez. Okay, for the sake of this actually being interesting for the camera and not, oh look, I didn't get anything. Go to six? Yeah. I don't mind.
I'm getting like, I don't know if I sorted this out at some point, but like, when I do get lands, they're always the same. Like, we got two of the same lands.
But you're doing the right thing now by, you know, making them break apart their little club, or whatever they're on about. So it's Death and Taxes, but you'll note when I get to playing, hopefully you'll note, the inordinate number of artifact and enchantment creatures. EVA, I was trying to think of what to call it other than Death and Taxes. Like, Enlightened Death and Taxes doesn't sound very good. I think it doesn't roll off the tongue. EVA, which is the name of my daughter. It was the deck I was going to play when she came and kept me from going to that tournament. And I think it stands for Enchantments versus Artifacts.
Were you, like, getting ready to go?
Yeah. Well, it was pretty close to it, yeah, actually. Howdy, howdy.
Yeah, I went into labor Thursday night, very early Friday morning. He was actually working on his deck. I went into labor, mm-hmm. So. Right now, she's like, my inn is in shambles. There are corpses
everywhere. She was like, would it have been keepable at five? Our entire town. Well, is it keepable at six even? What's going on
here? It might be people, it might not be. I'll try it.
Okay, we're gonna do this bit again. Spell Sky again. Alright, you're good. Good news is, no wasteland. At least not yet. Yes, faster?
I'll say, this isn't your modern deck.
No, this isn't either of our modern decks. Nevermore? You know what I'm naming. Restore balance.
Okay.
Last turn, and I take two of them. He can still win, of course. He just has to win off the value plan instead of the disrupt everything you ever thought you could do plan. Or let me just exile the Spell Sky and put a Fate counter. And so I helped him with what he needed. Fate luck counter.
So he goes and finds my manager. And of course she does the magic, like she has to keep her wall. We go to the back room and we have a good laugh.
Tricky.
I never want to inspire you to write that piece of paper. But I'll talk with you.
Yeah.
I think normally, yeah, that would be good. He has so many, which doesn't work. Alright, one man of any kind. You're at five now, so nothing. Another crystal bane or archaeological dig, and I'm just.
Involved.
It's red white.
He came
it's
up
red
to me
white.
Before he left, and he said, I hope you have a really good day. He probably thought that I was going to like lose my job on the spot.
I could just have that worm show, or whatever it is.
That's weird.
The giant thing show. With an overlay of it. And if that's the case, this does me actually no good.
Not too much. I'm still relatively new around here, but
sometimes it's like this really nasty curve that goes around a little bit and you make a highway and then left the turn lanes with this old Athens.
Yeah.
And sure enough, this woman takes a left.
Hmm.
I'm going right behind her now. And then she sees somebody else at the stop sign.
Yeah.
And so she's literally walking the entire road, just chatting with this chick.
Oh,
and there's like a half mile of cars behind me. And finally, I just
don't care.
Yeah. And then I turned down the street. I just do so that.
Decent family.
She walked the road.
Faster?
On like every
minute. And I take two.
Your question, you could use that.
There's another vein. Okay. Let's do it.
Oh, yeah.
Back for white.
Yep. Oh, boy. Here it comes. Here comes the big guy. Listed one. So, wait a minute. You're tapping for green. Oh, yeah, yeah. That's right. That's right.
Violent two colors.
Violent outburst. And then from there, you just go to hit restore balance. And... So, we have an enlisted worm. Not our armada worm. Enlisted worm.
You may play it without playing. Is that casting?
Yes, it's cast.
Are you sure?
I'm sure. Yeah.
But it's put into play by ability.
What are we on about? The,
it says play.
Oh yeah. So, Enlisted Worm is cast trigger, and Violent Outburst is cast trigger, and then Restore Balance. But yeah. You don't have to cast it, obviously you can't anyway, but you know.
No.
And so Violent Outburst is, it was cast so that you could keep going to the Restore Balance. And no haste, I think, right? It's just a vanilla. Once it's resolved, it's a vanilla. Alright, let's do something. You're late as usual, I guess. That's my deck for you.
Can't really showcase a combo when the combo gets killed.
Stoneforge Mystic?
Okay.
Getting Batterskull?
I'm
going to try to come back, but we'll see.
Come back. What?
Enlisted Worm is kind of hard to... do anything to right now, I'll admit. There we go. Pass turn. I'm at 15, you're at 20. Yeah, that's good. You can see the exiled spell sky and the deck. I don't know, wherever. Definitely no blocks.
What is that face for?
That's cute. That's too cute.
Her faces. She likes to make faces.
Oh.
Hmm. This is how we do it. Enlightened Tutor? Go and get an artifact or enchantment and put it on the top of the library. Alright, so that's exiled. That's my graveyard. I'm getting an Ancient Den, which is an artifact land that produces life. So banded by it. And can we just shortcut and make that my draw? Because that's what's about to happen anyway. So, technically though, it's top and then draw. Just guarantee myself a land draw. I should have checked to see. Oh, if you'd like to come.
She was also the Alright, oh, she was.
Equip Stoneforge with Sword of Feast and Famine.
So like, I hit the bottom of the hill. She just stops at the very bottom of the hill.
She gets out of her car, walks around in my car, and the only thing she says to me, like, I roll up my window, I'm like, here we go.
Pass turn. Oh yeah, yeah. Let's not play with the deck all the way out there.
So he jams. So basically, Amaris is she goes.
This will be a really nice day.
Lock with Stoneforge Mystic. In response, before damage, tap. Pay two, it goes seven.
Yeah,
put out a batter spell. Oh, we don't have the jump. I'm gonna have to pause for just a moment. This is very, very important. I promise you, this is important.
Yeah, it's strange because strange.
It has a top hat. I don't know, I had to. Anyway, so.
So Stoneforge dies?
No, it's pro green. So it took no damage from the Mystic Armor.
It's not like you were. Like,
that's your turn?
Narrow neighborhood, like off to the side where nobody ever drives.
Oh, yeah. If that was the case, I would have just exactly.
Really worried about Horizon Canopy. But Batter Skull's out now.
So, do you guys.
It's not sexist when you're as big as you or me, you know what I mean?
Okay. I don't even remember
what it was, like 3 years ago. Yeah, I got off so easy of my work. I was trying to shake his hand. Okay, see what he would do.
Wiggly butt. That sounds like a Pokemon.
As you guys walk out, she's like shooing you out.
I'm just
Wiggly
waiting for him butt. To come in again because he always comes in. I'm like, man, it's such a good day. I'm so glad
he's like pushing you guys out. Like,
I haven't job enough to
ever come back.
Well, if you ever want to have fun,
see you later.
I don't know if this would work there. If you're a
walk out.
The most douchebag thing I did.
As you guys walk out,
did it as a
repentant. Glory walks out. You guys.
GTA.
He's like, hey, I heard you drop.
She knows.
Since I don't have to worry about counter spells, I'll survive if I do that. The answer is yes, but not necessarily for me.
And you guys see that she's wearing what used to be desert.
Five? Equip. Swing. Four right here, and three right here. Swing seven. So, triggers, and I'll go up to nine again. Triggers. G-Tape. Sword of Feast and Famine. Do you have any cards in it? You'll need to discard one of your choice.
Oh, yeah.
Thank you. Isn't she precious?
I'm not sure if I had a problem with customer or not the other day because I picked up the phone and I did my usual phone answering. And they said, hi, I'm looking for a job.
Mr. Wizard.
I was like, well, if you call back tomorrow, you can speak to somebody who got paid with our hiring manager. And then I heard a really deep breath, and the loudest,
they are all, like,
they were no voice.
What is it?
Look at this.
She's precious, yeah.
And then they stopped and tried to scream again. And then I was holding it around.
They probably sort of like.
It's an interesting experience.
Yeah.
It's about how I imagine the normal customer over there.
Part.
Yeah. And you see the white works with a bottle of swing seven. And he seems to be
who's
like
you have a 3-4 pro green and a 4-4 with GT and two counters.
He was like,
I do. It was the first planeswalker in my estimation. It already has lifelink conventions, but it can now give -1/-1 to creatures, it can give +2/+2 to the equipped creature, or it can gain me life.
Here's how much it is.
Well, are you blocking?
No.
I will expend the two counters, I'll make it an 8-8, and you'll take 11. And then I'll go up to 17.
You see that he's got
get the two counters back, make you discard a card. Hit two for Vial and pass the turn.
That's gonna be dead.
So it's kind of death and taxes, but then you see weird stuff like Nevermore and Spellskite and
Stug, which can't really do anything against that.
Well, do you want to? Let's try it one more time. I think it can, if you don't mind. If you're
I mean, between like Nevermore and.
Well, that's a sideboard card for what it's worth.
Yeah, but still. Like Wasteland. That can't hold up against stuff like that.
Do you mind if we switch? Switch decks? Just for the game?
Watch that be the game that it goes off, right?
I don't know. So this will be interesting. We're cutting for ourselves over here.
Oh, it's not my bit.
Yeah, that's it. Alright. Who's going first? Should you go first because you lost, or should the deck go first because of I have no idea. Or yes. No. Okay. You got it. Your choice. Yeah. In that deck, you go first. It's no Manalist Dredge or anything silly like that. It's not ideal, but I can keep this. I'm interested though. You haven't cut lands from the deck.
Yeah. Did you get two of the same?
No.
You guys don't have to map real quick. But you can see the fire field down the range. On the distance.
So you have 20 lands in the deck.
You know that the tallest creature in the range is Dragon of the Strand, which is the one where the Afridi
is okay. Enlightened Tutor. It is an instant, so it doesn't matter right now. But if you want, you can. Do you mind if I take my turn? Ancient Spring Pass. So, yep, that's the one. That's the one to get.
I don't know what else is in here, but I know this.
It's a very good one. Oh, absolutely.
And this goes on top.
Yes. So you just drew it. Congrats. Yep. Krakus. Okay. I think it's just another planes against this deck. Oh, yeah. Okay. Sounds good. Or bad.
And he's
calls. He goes and talks to him for a few minutes and comes back. And he says that they
bad key. Bad key. Pastor.
That you could buy from them.
And our classy germ token over here with you. Yes, nevermore.
Restore balance?
Yes. Don't you want to name Wood Elemental? Alright, 18.
Wait a minute. We can't play that this turn.
No, that's right. I was too focused on the making a joke or whatever. You actually can untap one of those, because it's still a creature, so Thalia doesn't make it more expensive. Okay, I'm still at 18, yeah. You good?
Yeah, you can catch that.
Nope, that doesn't work.
Well, the thing is, you can tell whether stuff's magic by doing detect.
I'll spend more gas trying to get
to
that place.
No, I'm talking about this.
I'm still not used to it.
Why not?
Just for the...
That's balls. I don't know if that's where I need to be.
Cast a spell on the turret. And after a couple minutes, he tells you what
it is. Sacking it for black and paying blue. For a Cathari Remnant. Cascade. Shardless. And then we'll cascade to a hit restore balance.
Oh, I don't have double more out.
No, not right now.
It doesn't give you the ability to speak like
I should probably not keep my hand right in front of it so people can see what all is in. It's basically a deck to deck. I like it. Restore balance. There we go. And then put them in a random on the bottom. I think we actually resolved these separately, so the two cards... it doesn't matter. Whatever. It matters, but we're not in a competitive environment. I think the two cards that Remnant saw before hitting Shardless Agent would have been randomly... would have been put on the bottom of random order separately from the rest of these. Okay.
So do you have to pay one for Restore Balance? Because of Thalia?
Okay, that's right. No, good catch. Alright, so now I have a 2-2 and an 0-1. Dang, good job. On your game. That's what I did need to sack it, actually. Okay. That's what I get for not having experience.
Yeah, you'd have to change something to blue. You'd have to change or dig to blue.
Yeah, that's right, you're right. I'm sorry. Pass turn. Good catch, mate. I'm just bad, apparently. When you were looking through with the Enlightened Tutor, did you see any other cards other than Evermore?
I was just looking for that one.
Actually, there was another card that would have already sealed the game as well. It's a main board card that's obviously not made for this deck, but it's made for Storm. If you get an Aether Sworn Canonist out, then I'm dead. It shuts off Cascade. Which means that's in your hand, right? Okay, maybe not. I actually don't think there's anything in the deck you can cast for one with Thalia out.
What are you building? I've noticed that you guys are just kind of like
swords. Yes, I'm getting two.
I get my horse again.
Did I take two at some point? Oh, Thalia, okay. 20.
It is.
And then get rid of that. Right in front of the spirit bus, go back to 18.
Here we go. I think it's after.
Pass turn.
So,
I'll be at Tuesday.
Yes. Yeah. I might show Tuesday tomorrow. I can't
probably be here tomorrow.
Yeah, tomorrow. Right.
That germ, yep. Had to go out in the car to get it because it's that classy. And then it dies to stay base actions. Okay. Hey, yes. All right, you have expert.
Swing five.
13.
Deck's not very fun against this one.
And another ancient spring. Last turn. Finish Fluctuator so we can finally have a battle with silly decks. CascaBalance versus Fluctuator. I say silly, not silly. Cheap. Like, literally cheap, not figuratively cheap. Oh, jeez. What would you like to name? Yeah, I couldn't think of anything.
No. Niv-Mizzet.
Yes. All right, very important. Draco Genius or Firebind?
Not the player.
Okay. Wait. Divisit. No, need to spend. Yeah, you're right. It seems like it.
The one that pings.
Okay.
Sulfur falls.
Yep. Oh, sulfur vent? Yeah. There we go. I mean, I guess I'll just float it or whatever. And then that's turn. Oh, no, we're swinging. That's right. We're swinging. Ouch. Six. Alright. Ready for this? I will sack it to suspend restore balance. No. Alright, that's it. You got it.
Yeah.
That'll do. Yeah, there's an Aether Swarm cannon that's in the list for Storm. Yep. Another Wasteland. Wastelands are good. I admit, if anyone says this is a bad deck, if I had known that about the trick with Thalia being out, having a sack instead of just paying it for Xaxes, maybe that would have changed the game. Maybe not. Maybe not. 40 minutes. Oh, you do military time too?
Yeah, because when I lived on campus, I would set my alarm and have it all beaten, and I would miss all of my classes.
Yeah, I hear
so
you.
So I had to
make sense.
Make the change.
Nothing wrong with that. Alright. You're up?
Yeah.
Well, we have Japanese. Dot.
Wasteland.
Pass turn. Yeah. Game restarted. Welcome to Legacy. Where no one has any permanents out now.
Okay, I'll order this. Sir, 2 hours.
Welcome to Nobs. Let's see.
Yes. Yeah.
You got it. Do you think? Yeah.
Oh, yeah, they have a cap. I mean, I think Ted is like uncomfortable. Yeah, man, I mean, whatever works. It's like obnoxious to see it here.
They should make cascade cards that are single color. That'd be so much easier.
I think that maybe the idea would be too easy. Thalia? Master? No, I'm trying to debate that. I think I'd rather feel nothing at all, actually.
Standard's a little weird right now. Yeah. Especially this match.
Could get one loss because Bill aggressively helped out.
Did he really?
Well, it's
two.
Well, I'll let it happen because he's kind of like.
Last turn? This looks familiar.
Okay, so what was like Bill was like hanging up behind him like without you know
I see six mana. I don't see green yet. I mean I do, but not with six mana. Is that turn? Just making sure. Five? Vegas, last turn. This looks really familiar. We did not play.
No. The thing is, he's exactly like my brother.
I think it's just that your deck doesn't like you today. Did you not feed it or something?
Yeah, and then they have BA1.
Feed it some storm crows every now and then. Those are its favorites. I think. Always go big. And then if it doesn't work, then you can go home.
I had that moment where I was like,
he's good.
But I was like, can I do this?
Remembering that Thalia is going to make restore cost of work.
I kept a really bad hand because I knew he was going to not see some like two profits. So I just wanted him to see it and be like, get mad or do something stupid. So if he not sees two profits for both my profits, I left me like a quarter and this thing and like all the lands I did. So I knew that. But when he tried to downfall one of my profits in game one, I was like, in response, gosh, it was my first day. He was like, you're a douchebag. He literally told me that. I was like, okay, man, whatever works for you.
Yeah, it's like, I still win.
Yeah.
I'll take it.
Yeah.
Oh, that's funny.
Spoiler alert, I'm never casting Nevermore, apparently.
That happened to me.
Yeah.
My own Thalia keeping me from casting them.
Whatever I was like,
seven?
How many cards in hand? Seven. Thoughtseize. Cool, tap three, like, it's like spray, strike, or like, play.
Pass turn.
Yeah.
I'm sitting alone waiting for a good response to anything. And Thoughtseize was like the best.
Get something going on.
I'm gonna add things.
Go for it. Here we go. Here comes. Tap for green. Yes. Suck these. Here comes the worm. Alright, that'll get you the one over to take Thalia.
I'll have a white.
Now,
one colorless.
Okay. Now, if you hit any non-creatures before you get to restore balance, then that'll be an issue, because you only have the one mana to pay for one of your non-creatures. But I guess you have to do that because you need the green for this to work. Was it the first one? When you play it, okay, it still wants you, you still have to actually pay the mana to cast it as the trick. Oh, without paying its mana cost. Never mind, go for it. Never mind.
But that's an additional cost.
Without paying its mana cost, you still have to pay that? I know that with alternate
costs... The spells cost more.
Yeah. I know that with alternate cost, like Flashback Dread Return, you still have to pay one, even though it doesn't require any mana normally.
Is that stock cast?
We have a judge here, actually, right now. We can ask him just to make absolutely sure.
I mean, he's
all right. Give us just one sec. I got to yell at one of the random people in the store, like, "Judge!" So that'll do it. Man. Well, you can stall the game. Oh, and by the way, no, that's right.
There you go.
Just a moment. Bounce the Thalia. Return a legendary creature. It's still legendary.
For some reason, I thought it was like from your graveyard.
Enlightened Tutor.
Good morning.
But you have to pay. No, you bounce. Okay.
Yeah, bounce Thalia. Ancient Den?
I guess you could have just paid the two. Not else.
I need it for something else going on. There's something else happening too. It's just a land. I'm guaranteeing myself a land. Would you like to cut the rest of it?
It's an odd card for them to make.
Yeah. Mirrodin was weird. These, all the colored artifact lands are banned. Just make affinity 2 of me. Which I draw. This is why I had to bounce with Thalia. Oblivion Ring? I can get you to 1 this turn, but I can't kill you. This turn.
Is that Uri?
Time for Bloodbraid Elf or Shardless Agent to make their appearance, I guess.
Back.
Yes. Shards, okay. One floating. Yeah, it's restored balance. Alright. Yep. How many cards do you have in your hand?
Six.
So do I. Okay. So that part doesn't happen, but now you have a Shards agent, and I am out of stuff.
Well, you get to keep it. No, that's on the stack.
Yeah, that's right. It's on the stack.
So I have to discard?
No. We're both at 6.
Okay.
Here we go. Pass turn. Uh-oh. Yeah, I mean 18. It can happen. Pass turn. I'll take one to swords you, or you go up to three.
I know, I was like, you didn't mean to do that.
Okay. I just didn't know it was like, no, I mean, if it's like a cheap card like that, that's more like a, like, I'll give you positive feedback. Generally speaking, quality is fine, but then it's like, I'll send you a message.
I can't do that in instance.
Watch it, because you get the nice people next time.
Now we nihilate. Okay.
Of course.
Oh, do you have to sack the stronghold?
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, this is going to be fun. You're at three?
You have like four people in charge of.
I'm going to take one and make you have an answer for it now.
Which I don't have land.
Yeah, you don't have anything that's like one drop to deal with the spirit. And then swing next turn. Does a. That was actually pretty close. Okay. Good job, mate.
An oblivion ring.
Dead ring. I also had a Nevermore lodged in my hand permanently that game.
Can I be playing for an oblivion?
Can you?
Well, saying how soon are we going to be leaving?
The other one was a Sword of Feast and Famine. That's actually Fire and Ice is main board, Feast and Famine is sideboard. So I considered other cards like Humility. You won't be able to. I don't think you actually have a way to remove Humility in the deck. But if I worked with you on getting some Force of Wills in the deck, do you think you'd be okay with that? I know Enlisted Worm can hit Force of Will, but you can either keep them in the sideboard and then side out Enlisted Worm against certain matches where just, you know, countering your spells is just that important. Or you can put them in the main board and then Enlisted Worm goes in the sideboard. I don't know. I'm just throwing it at folks. And then the side outs.
I love you, Commandeer.
I have a combo in the deck. Yeah, Commandeer. There we go. I have a combo, Rest in Peace and Helm of Obedience. You've seen this before. And exile all cards in all graveyards, as long as it's in play. And then Helm of Obedience is weird. It's actually, I don't think it's as unintuitive as people say it is. You pay X, where X is greater than 1. And then you tap it, put the top X cards, or until they hit a creature of a from an opponent's library, into the graveyard. So in and of itself, without even reading the rest of it,
so creatures would stop and nothing else would. It would just keep going further.
Well, with Rest in Peace, I pay 1 mana, so X equals 1, and tap it, and then top card. Well, it didn't hit the graveyard, it exiled, so I keep going. So it didn't hit the graveyard, exiled, so I keep going. It just exiles your deck. As long as I can target you, and as long as I have 1 mana, it just gives the deck an alternate way to win. If it can't win through combat...
Has this been, like, confirmed?
Yeah, like, absolutely. It's
not like it is being put in the graveyard and it's redirected.
Oh, no, it's being... If a card would be put into the graveyard, it's exiled instead, so this replacement effect makes it go to the...
Yeah. It's kind of like that stuffy doll.
Yeah, that... I heard about that.
I don't want to do that.
A friend of ours. What was... Guilty Conscience, I think, was the other
one? Yeah.
That seems so silly, and yet...
Like, it takes damage working. Anyway, and it does infinite damage to itself doing infinite damage to itself.
That's right. I mean, on the... Stuffy Doll's 5 mana, though? I think I have a hard time seeing that being terribly viable for that reason. Although, it could just be heavily control-oriented. I don't know. What do I know?
Quite a lot.
What do you want? I'm just kidding. See you two. I'll bring Infect next time so that we can finish that match. Finally. Finally. See you later, mom.